Hello everyone, I'm going to start a new resin painting, but first of all I want to thank some people. I want to thank Evelyn for sending me those great silicone pans, so I'm going to try them out and I will let you know. And I also want to thank Dolores and Laurie for supporting me and that way also this channel. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. So if you watch this video, Evelyn, Dolores and Laurie, thank you so much. So what I already said, I'm going to make another resin painting and I want to make it very colorful. And I already painted my canvas. I used 2 layers of gesso and I used 2 layers of acrylic paint. And I painted it black and white. I do this because I want to have a reference where I want the darker colors. And yeah, I already put some black on a darker on the black paint. So I use the black base tint of Stone Coat. And I also use the Stone Coat Art Coat resin. I like that resin very much for these kinds of paintings. And I'm going to use the swipe technique again. So yeah, let's see how that goes. But I'm going to use very bright colors. All the materials I'm using are listed in the beginning of this video and also in the description box with the links where I buy my materials. So if you want to see that, then go to the description box. There you can find all the information. So with my stirring stick I push the black resin where I want it. And remember, don't put too much black base tint in your resin. If you put too much in it, then all the effects you are getting are going away during drying because the resin gets too thin. So only a little bit of that black base tint of Stone Coat in your resin. You don't need a lot. So the first color I'm using is the Egyptian blue of Artisu. Very nice color, no sparkle, but I like that if I have colors that sparkle and colors that don't. The next color is the cool mint of Lores, also a very nice color, also no sparkle. This is also a very nice color. It's from Color Art, the Red Plum. Yeah, I still need to buy a daylight lamp because the lighting is not that good. This is the Sapphire Blue of Lores, but then the paste, not the powder. It's also not sparkly. And I pour the colors next to the black of Stone Coat and next to each other. Again, the cool mint of Lores next to the black. And the spiced ginger of Color Art. And that's a very sparkly color. So I'm using sparkly colors and colors that don't have any sparkle. And then I'm going to swipe them over each other. Again, the Red Plum of Color Art. I'm also almost done with my studio. So I'm going to make a video of that so you can see what I did. That's the bright gold of Artisu. Very nice sparkly gold color. I like that very much. a little bit of heat, but remember, don't put too much heat on it, because then you don't get the effects you want. And now I'm going to swipe the gold over the red plum into the black, and I'm using Yupo paper. So you lay your paper very gently on top of the color, and very gently you drag it into the black. And after that, a little bit of heat, not too much, and then you will get some effects. Again, the cool mint over the Egyptian blue into the black, and then a little bit of heat. So I do the same with the spiced ginger over the cool mint and then into the black of stone coat. And then I hope I get some nice effects, some lacing or some large cells, who knows. Also the sapphire blue over the red plum into the black, and then a little bit of heat, and they're already forming some cells or lacing. Now I'm pouring some white base tint between the color, and I'm spreading it with my stirring stick. Yeah, and I'm using for my swipes, I'm using Yupo paper. That's a paper that has a plastic layer on both sides, so you can wipe them with some alcohol and then use them again. I also saw that in one of the videos of Leslie of Color Art, and that's a great idea. Then you don't have to throw them away, but you also can use freezer paper, or I don't know how you call that in the USA. But that kind of paper you can also use. But I like this one because it's a little bit thicker. So next to the white, I'm pouring some cool mint of Lurrez. And some sapphire blue of Lurrez. And now I'm going to swipe it the other way. Now I'm going to swipe it into the white. That's the spiced ginger of Color Art. And I'm using different sizes of swipe paper. That's a very small one. Yeah, and I'm liking this technique very much. You get all kinds of beautiful effects. There you can see very well the sapphire blue, very nice color of Lurrez. And then a little bit of heat. Again, the red plum, such a nice sparkly color of Color Art. And they work so very well in the resin. They mix instantly. And it's going to be a very colorful painting. But I like bright colors. Again, the Egyptian blue of Artisou. And I swipe it into the white. some heat again, not too much, because otherwise I'm losing all my effects and I'm liking them. Now I'm working on the sides, but I don't want to cover the whole sides because I like that dripping effect. Yeah, you don't see the colors that are good on the video. But what I already said, I'm going to buy more daylight lamps. But at the end of this video, also a close-up in the sunlight. I hope you can see the colors a little bit better. Also the torch for the air bubbles. I do this several times. Also during drying. And the stone coat art coat dries a little bit slower than the Mastercast I use for my geodes. This is a drying time of 24 hours. So the first hour I'm checking if there are new air bubbles. And I remove them with my torch. But I'm liking this art coat very much for these kinds of paintings. For my geodes I'm going to use Mastercast because that's a little bit thicker resin. And then you don't have a problem when you pour lines that they flow too much to the sides. But for these kinds of paintings, yeah, the art coat is very good for it. And also it has a nice finish, looks like glass. Again the torch. And I'm liking what I have. Really nice lacing. So almost done, and then we can go to the close-up. So this is how it looks after about 12 hours of drying. Very bright colors. I like it very much. Some amazing effects. Some great lacing. I like it. There you can see the sapphire blue and the cool mint. And also the red plum of color art. Very sparkly. Some very large cells. Also the spiced ginger I dragged over the cool mint of Lares. Yeah, I'm very proud of this painting. I like colorful paintings, and yeah, this painting is colorful, so yeah, it's amazing. I hope you all like it too. Leave a comment under this video, a little bit closer. There you can see the bright gold of Artie Sue together with the red plum of color art. Very nice. Sorry for my reflection. You can see me also in the video. There the cool mint on top of the spiced ginger, a lot of depth. There the sapphire blue of Lares with some cells. Very nice, and I especially like this part with the sapphire blue and the red plum of color art. Very nice lacing on top of the black of stone coat. Also this part with the spiced ginger. Very nice. Yeah, and these effects you can get if you use the black base tint of stone coat. It's a very good pigment. And you don't have to use a lot. the red plum on top of the white base tint of stone coat. Very nice. The cool mint of Lares. Some nice cells. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video. That would help me a lot. If you have tips, comments or questions, please place them under the video. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. All the links to the materials are in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching this video. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.